Hello, buddy, and welcome. My husband and I have been invited to a wedding at the end of March. It is currently almost the end of February. I have about a week left, and I have been researching for weeks what I want to do. It's been really hard figuring it out just because I have so many ideas, and then I get a little bit frozen with so many choices before me. So I have decided what I want to do, and I have figured out the fabric I'm going to be using. And so I thought perhaps if this would help you, I do have a long list of patterns that I was considering for a very long time. I wanted to show you all of the patterns that made my long list in case you have a special occasion coming up, as a wedding or a birthday or any kind of special occasion, or you just want to make a really nice party dress, because these are all dresses as well. And so, yeah, I wanted to show you that today. But if you're new here, my name is Sarah. I am originally from the United States, and I moved to France in 2009, and I've been here ever since. I now live and work here. I am a dual citizen of both countries, and on this channel, I share mostly my sewing projects, but a little bit of other creative endeavors that I dabble in from time to time, such as knitting or embroidery or whatever the future brings. And I do like to share a little bit of my private life or personal life here, just a little bit, because there are lots of things outside of the sewing room that inspire me, in case it inspires you too. So welcome. So this list today, I have, I think, five or six patterns to show you, including the one or the hacked two patterns that I'm going to create the dress that I want to make. I think that there are a few patterns on this list that you've probably already seen before, just because they're very popular for special occasions, especially going to a wedding as a guest. But I do think that there are perhaps other patterns that you may not have heard of before because they are from French pattern makers, and so I'm really excited to show you those today. Let me first show you the fabric that I will be using. So this is a really beautiful viscose fabric that I found. I found it at an online fabric shop, although they might have a physical shop as well, based in Belgium, called C'est du Joli. And this is a Mind the Maker fabric. It is 100% viscose, and it has this really, really beautiful drape. I just love these colors. It's sort of a royal blue on a navy blue background, and then these little petals that are a very light sort of beigey pink. And I have 3.5 meters. I think it's called the Leia Cobalt Blue fabric, if you want to check it out as well. But yeah, I'm really excited about this fabric. I do want to make something that is midi length, so not floor length, but longer than knee length. And I think I have enough to make something out of this. The only concern I have is that, so I've noticed with fabrics that are printed specifically for sewists, sort of designer fabrics, such as, I've never sewn with a Mind the Maker fabric before, but I'm thinking of Atelier Brunet, for example, the French brand. I've noticed that although their fabrics are beautiful and the colors are really saturated and rich and absolutely gorgeous, a lot of times the viscose is loosely woven, and I have worked with fabrics before that, even though they are visually very gorgeous, they start to fall apart at the seams after a wear or two, and I would be devastated if that happened with this fabric. Although I probably won't wear this dress very often, but I don't want it falling apart at the seams no matter what, after so much time spent on it, and it's not the cheapest fabric. So I will report back. I will make it and report back and let you know how it goes. But basically, my worry comes from the fact that I tried to find the grain line, yeah, along this edge, and as I was pulling, so it was impossible to rip it, as you do sometimes. But with this one, because it's more of a delicate fabric, I was just pulling one of the strands along the width of the fabric to follow it, and it kept breaking. And so I know that the fibers or the strands, the individual threads of this fabric, are sort of weak. And then it sort of broke apart rather than ripping. And so I think that the weave is quite open, and a little bit more like a, not paste, I don't know why I'm thinking of a paste, but you know that kind of sort of sticky sort of pull apart that sometimes fabrics have? It acted like that. So we'll see. It has this really, really beautiful drape, and it's opaque, and I think it's going to serve the purpose that I want it for. I just really, really hope that it turns out well. So now let me show you the patterns I was looking at. So the first pattern I would like to show you today is one that you probably already know. I know that I've seen it a lot on Instagram, for example, and I know that people really like making it for things like going to a wedding. And so it is the Sicily slip dress by Sewing by Mason. This is a cowl neck slip dress with two strap options, so one more of a skinny strap and one a little bit wider. And it is bias cut, so it sort of flutes over the belly and the hips and sort of flutes out at the hem, which is about midi length. And it is absolutely gorgeous. I like that the cowl neck is lined, so it's just fabric flipped over down to about the ribs, and so you have this really nice soft fold in the front, and it looks really, really lovely. I have my notes here because I can't remember everything off the top of my head, so please forgive me if I read a little bit. So this pattern is available in sizes A to J, which is a 33 to a 54 inch bust, and I think it would be really beautiful in both a solid sort of satiny fabric as well as a big print or something that like a sort of print that you'd like to show off, as with this fabric. And I was considering it, but I have made this dress before. I made it once before in a viscose that had sort of a berry toned flowery design and a beige background, and it didn't work for me for two reasons. The first was the beige background didn't look very nice against my skin, and so I never really reached for it. And then the shape of the dress I found wasn't entirely flattering. So it's not a question of flattering or not flattering. I think it's more I feel a little bit self-conscious about my hips and my belly, and even though the cowl neck does balance out like the volume on the top, it's not super tight on top. I do think that the fluting sort of makes the hips look a little bit bigger, and it does hug the belly. And I think I feel very sensitive, or I feel very self-conscious when my belly is out or visible. I much prefer skirts with volume to sort of dissimulate a little bit what's going on underneath. Not that I think that I have a problem with my body or anything. It's just, I just feel very exposed. I feel almost nude in a dress like this one because the bias clings. And I think that it looks really beautiful on a lot of people and a lot of different body shapes. And so I don't mean this to dissuade you as either. It's just my personal taste, and I would like to one day be a little bit more comfortable with wearing clothes like that, just because I think it is so feminine. And it's such a celebration of feminine curves, or the feminine sort of curvy bits of the body. And yeah, I think it's so powerful to be able to have confidence in that, but not this time. I would like to try this pattern again, but not this time. The second pattern that I wanted to show you today is called the Adriana dress by French pattern maker Coralie Bijesson. And I'm pretty sure the majority, if not all, of her patterns are available in English if you'd like to go check them out. But this dress is interesting in its shape in that it's very balletic, I find, with the dropped waist and the leotard-like upper half, and then the flowy sort of looser half. It's not tulle, but it reminds me of the shape of the costumes in the Balanchine Ballet Serenade, and it's such a beautiful ballet. I've never actually seen it, I've only seen clips. I'd like to see it one day, but that's a tangent. This pattern features, so, a princess-seamed bodice with small straps, a dropped waist, and then smocking in the back for a very comfortably snug fit. And then a tiered skirt with the option of removing one of the three tiers to make it more knee length rather than midi length. This pattern is available in sizes 34 to 48, so a 32 to a 43 and a fourth inch bust. And I think that this pattern would be really beautiful in either a very floaty viscose with a lot of drape, or a cotton or linen voile, so a very light sort of cotton or linen. For a little bit more structure in the tiered skirt, for example. And I think it would look really nice with sort of a smaller, ditzier print, or a big print to show off the print, although it would get a little bit distorted in the smocking in the back. Personally, if I made this pattern, I would probably raise the waistline from a high hip length to, or high hip position, to a natural waist position, just because I think that it's an interesting look. But I have, my hips are two sizes wider than my bust, and I think that that sort of shape, I'm not sure if I would like that. I grew up in the early 2000s for some information, and the fashion at the time was very, very low rise jeans. And I remember wearing that as a teenager, and it was fine before my hips popped. But after that, I felt a little bit more self-conscious about that shape and having, I don't know, a seam there. I think that it's not very flattering on me, for example. But anyway, also I think that I would prefer to make it in something with a little more structure, so a cotton or a linen voile, and so that would make it a little bit more of a summer dress. And since this wedding is taking place at the end of March, which is sort of the cusp between the end of winter and the beginning of spring, I think that I'd like something a little bit more somber. Sober? Is that, how do you pronounce that word? I would like something that's has a little bit more gravitas in the way it looks and hangs, especially with this color. And I think that, yeah, I would definitely make this pattern, but more as a summer dress. The next dress that I'd like to talk to you about is the Sovi Sundress by Sohouse 7. And you have probably seen this dress a few times on this channel or on my Instagram page because I have made it twice. I find this dress really interesting in that it is both sort of classic and elegant, but casual at the same time. And so it's very versatile for a lot of different events. I first made it in a light blue linen, so a lightweight blue linen, for my birthday 2 years ago, and I wore it also to a friend's wedding at the end of August when it was really, really hot, and it was perfect because it was light and floaty and not too hot in August. And I also wore this dress to my own town hall wedding ceremony back last spring, and so I really love this dress, and I really love that version. And then I also made a viscose version, so a completely different drape and sort of hang to the dress or structure. And I made a whole video journal of that process. If you'd like to watch that video, I'll link it to this one here. And what I did to add a little bit more structure to the bodice was add a little bit more, not facing, I'm losing my words in English. Interfacing, sorry. To create a little bit more structure in the bodice, I add a little bit more interfacing to the top half, just so that it wasn't too floaty and hangy. And I also took in the side seams a little bit because I didn't want it to blouse over the waistband as much. But I do like this dress, and I think that it was very successful for the event that I made it for, a wedding at the end of October. And yeah, I really like that version too. So this dress features a fully lined bodice with a V-neck in the front and a low V-neck in the back. And it has front darts and an optional waistband, and it has two different skirt options, including really deep pockets, which is very, very useful for an event like a wedding when you don't want to carry a bag around all the time and you want to just put something like your phone or lipstick in your pockets. And it features two different skirt options. One is an A-line skirt without any ruffles or tiers, with side slits at the side, for movement, and then the second one is a tiered skirt with a ruffle at the bottom along the hem. And I've always made the version with the ruffle hem and with the waistband, but you can make it without the waistband as well. And I find that this pattern is really great for adventurous beginners because you learn techniques that are a little bit trickier, such as gathering. There's a lot of gathering if you make that tiered skirt, or inserting a waistband elastic with stitching along the waistband because it is a very wide elastic, which makes it very comfortable, but sometimes stretching out the fabric to make those stitching lines is a little bit complicated. And if you make it in a cotton or linen voile like my first version, it's a lot easier to work with than a viscose. So I highly recommend making this one. It is available in sizes 00 to 20, which is a 31 to a 47 inch bust. And in the end, I decided not to make this one just because I think I prefer it in the light blue cotton linen as more of something that I can wear more versatile. I think that the viscose version is a little bit more dressy and something that I don't reach for, especially in the fall or winter, as the colors sort of correspond to, because it's not as warm and I don't have a whole lot of events that I would go to except for maybe the holidays in the wintertime with that dress. So I think for me it's a little bit more like in the name or in the title of this pattern, a sundress and something for the summer and warmer months. So I won't be making this one, but I highly recommend making it. I enjoyed making it and I enjoyed wearing it. The next pattern that I was looking at was the Sophia dress by Sew Over It, and this dress I think recently published last summer, and it's another more summery dress, but I've been intrigued, and I think that the main point of intrigue for me is the detail in the back. So this pattern features a slight sweetheart neckline with wide straps that are bra friendly with a little bit of gathering in the bodice for shaping, and then in the back it closes with either a bow or a button-up detail, and it has a lower back cutout. And I've never worn either a bow like that or a cutout, even though the cold shoulder trend was definitely in fashion for a while a few years ago and very tempting, but I'd like to try it. I think that the lower back cutout is flattering on everyone in every shape and just really interesting. This also features a tiered skirt. It's a little more in the trend of tiered skirts as well. This dress is available in sizes 6 to 30, so a bust size 31 to 57, and I think it would be really beautiful in both a drapey viscose like this one or a cotton or linen voile or a fabric a little bit more structure. And the only concern I have about this one is I don't understand how you get into it by yourself, because that bow or those buttons in the center back look really difficult to reach by yourself. And there's no stretchy element to it, like there's no smocking in the back, so you can't just fit it over your shoulders and just go. So I suppose perhaps it's low enough in the back that it's a little bit easier, but yeah. Interesting. But in the end, I think that this one as well is more of a summer dress. And I think the tiered skirt looks a little bit better in fabrics with structure, which is what I learned with the Sobeys sundress. And so, yeah, this is definitely going to stay on my list, but I won't be making it this time. The last pattern that I was considering on my long list that I ultimately decided not to make but that will stay on my to make list is the Puma dress by Oz Patterns. She is a French pattern maker, independent and solo. I know Monty personally, so this is slightly personally biased, but I am not sponsored. This video is not sponsored in any way, shape, or form. So this dress is a classic wrap dress, which is the quintessential wedding guest dress that a lot of people wear, and I think it's because it's universally flattering, and depending on the fabric that you choose, you can make it a little bit more structured or casual or flowy and romantic. So I think it's very versatile. And I chose this one because it had a few very interesting details. So there are some very popular wrap dress patterns for woven fabrics, and they're all gorgeous as well. But I picked this one because it has a sort of style that is not as flowy and romantic and feminine. It has, so it features a V-neck bodice, or it's a wrap dress, so, but the V-neck isn't too low or too high, I find. It's just the perfect, so to highlight the collarbones, but not go too far into the cleavage. And then it has gathers at the shoulders and also at the waist for a little bit of shaping. And then you have two sleeve options. So there's either a short grown-on sleeve that ends just about cap sleeve length, or there is a lower sleeve attachment that goes to the elbow with an elastic, and it has volume. So it's an interesting looking sleeve. I don't know what it's called, the shape, but it's something that I haven't seen before, and I find it very on trend as well if you want to go for the big sleeve trend. And then it has a thin waistband elastic that attaches both on the inside and the outside for security. And then the skirt is a little bit more of a straight skirt. It's slightly A-lined, but it's not too floaty. It doesn't have like a high-low hem or anything. And it just looks very simple, like simple understated elegance. And that's what I love about Monty's patterns, is that it's, yeah, they're all a little bit of a mix of the sort of gamine shape, and gamine is a little bit tomboyish, for example, like feminine but tomboyish at the same time, very Audrey Hepburn, for example. And I think that it's something that I haven't really experimented with very much before, because I have more of a feminine shape with my smaller waist and bigger hips. For example, I'm not super small all over. But I think that it looks really beautiful on everyone. This wrap dress looks really beautiful on all of the pattern testers or the people who've made this pattern. And I like this sort of understated elegance. I like that you can also make it in all sorts of kinds of fabrics too. She suggests, for example, even a wool fabric for the winter time, or you can do a whole lot with this one. And I just think it's really interesting. But ultimately, I decided not to make this dress because I think that although I really love the rounded shoulder shape of this dress, I find it a little bit more casual than what I would like to wear. I want something a little bit more sort of glamorous and that shows off a little bit more of my collarbones and shoulders. And so ultimately it did help me find what I wanted to wear. So let me show you that now. So this is fortunate and unfortunate at the same time. I actually am filming this video for the second time because I have gotten a new camera recently. I think you might have noticed in the last video or two, and I am learning how to use it, and it is hard. And I realized that with the video that I filmed a few days ago, the audio was awful, like painfully awful to listen to, and so I had to start again. But this actually also permitted me to rethink what I wanted to say and sort of refine what I wanted to say, and then also really figure out what I wanted to make, because in the first video I had said something entirely different. Well, not entirely, but somewhat different. And this really helped me, yeah, refine my ideas. And so what I will be making is two patterns hacked together. So a top bodice and then a skirt hacked together from two different patterns. They're both sew over patterns, and the top half is going to be the rosy dress. This pattern features a princess seamed bodice, which I really love the look of. I love making princess seamed bodice. It is fully lined, just the top half, and it features boning as well along the seams. And this is something that I've done before and for my wedding dress bodice, and it ended up really helping support the weight of the skirt and also keep the fabric close to my torso. And so I will be using that again. It's not uncomfortable in the slightest. It's a little bit tricky to install, but I think it's going to be worth it. And then it features two different necklines. So the first one is more of a vintage straight sort of square neckline with a collar and wide straps. And then the second one is a very slight sort of subtle sweetheart neckline without a collar and with skinny straps. I'm going to make the second version, so the slight sweetheart neckline with the skinny straps, and I think it's going to look really lovely in this fabric. I will have to add a little bit of structure to it, just because I think that this fabric is sort of drapey and a little bit too drapey to support the structure that I'd want in a princess seam bodice against my torso, and then also for supporting the weight of the skirt, I think that it needs a little bit more structure and the boning, so that the boning doesn't sort of poke out of the fabric. So I will be definitely interfacing the fashion fabric, so this fabric on this side, and then I will be probably lining it with a light cotton or linen voile for a more tighter woven structured hold. And so I will do that and let you know how it goes. But then for the skirt, originally I was going to use the rosy skirt and just lengthen it to midi length, because I want a midi length skirt. But I had in my head this idea that I would really like something flowy, but also with sort of a side slit to kind of break up that line a little bit, because otherwise it's just a block of this really vibrant fabric. And so I ended up deciding after filming the first time that I wanted to actually make the Kate skirt be the bottom half of this dress. So the Kate skirt is from the Work to Weekend ebook by Sew Over It as well, and I've made it once before in a viscose twill in a really beautiful sort of burgundy fabric, and it's very floaty and it has a very nice heavy hang to it, and I love wearing it. I don't know if I'll include all of the slits. So it features the options for side slits and a front slit, because it's a paneled skirt. There's a front panel and then side panels to just the front half. And so you have, with the paneling, options to add slits. And in the original, or in the first version that I made, just the skirt, I didn't include any of the slits. I think that for this one, I will include only the front side slit, and I will lengthen it about 10, maybe 15 inches, so that it's midi length, because it's currently maybe 3 inches below the knee sort of length. And I think that'll look really nice. I'm a little bit worried that it'll be a little bit, I don't know. Sometimes I like having gathers at the waist. It might be a little bit clingier, a little bit more form fitting, but it is drapey, I think. And I think the Kate skirt includes a lot of volume, sort of a more A-line fluted volume versus gathering in a square sort of volume hang to it. I think it'll be nice, but that is what I want to make. I have made the rosy bodice before as well. I made it once for my 30th birthday, actually, in a really beautiful Italian linen. It was white with sort of a beautiful lily or flower motif on it, and I really love that version. So I made it with the vintage sort of collar and square neckline and the wide straps. So I've never made the second version before, And yeah, I'm really excited to get to it. And I hope it's going to go well. So that is what I will be making for this wedding at the end of March. And I'm really excited because these are good friends and I think we're going to have a really fun time. And I think I'm going to feel fabulous in this fabric. But we'll see. I'll let you know. I'll make sure to include in the description below all of the patterns that I've mentioned here, just in case you'd like to check them out. And if you've made them before, let me know your feedback. I'd love to know how it went and if you enjoyed making them and wearing them as well. And if you have a special event coming up soon and you're planning on making a garment for it, I would love to hear what you're going to make. I love hearing back from you and it's always very interesting for me, so don't hesitate to leave a comment below. I am currently wearing the Sew Over It Heather dress, or my latest one, if you saw my video about sweater dresses and all of my heather dresses. I'm really happy with this one. It's very stretchy and cozy and soft. But I will show you in much more detail in a video coming out very soon about everything I've made in the wintertime. So watch this space. I hope that you enjoyed this video and that you are all doing very well. I will see you again here soon. Bye-bye.